Touchdown, Blazers!
The Hal Mumme Show, your weekly look at Valdosta State University Blazer football with head coach Hal Mumme, is brought to you by Anheuser-Busch and Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. The Florida Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Coca-Cola Classic. Always a winner, always Coca-Cola. Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right. Nations Bank, an official sponsor of the 1996 U.S. Olympic team. Swanee Swifty, designed with your convenience in mind. Wendy's, the best hamburger and a whole lot more. And Winn-Dixie, America's supermarket.
Richard Smith under the center, almost dropped it. Now we get hit in the backfield, safety. Andre Hampton in there for the safety as they pitched it deep to Messiah Porter. Set back with him in the backfield. It's Dominique Ross, going to be the blocking back, going to throw it down the field to the flash, going to come back and catch it. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Valdosta State University.
Hello again and welcome to the Hal Mumme Show. I'm your host, John Lastinger, along with the head coach of the Valdosta State University Blazers, Coach Hal Mumme.
And I'm excited to be here to bring y'all all these highlights of our fine win over Ford Valley.
And that it was. The VSU Blazers amassed a school record, 599 yards of offense, led it 51-6 at halftime and cruised to a 58-6 victory over Fort Valley State College. Coach, a lot of offense in the first half.
Well, that was fun to watch, and our players played well. Our defense played great, John, but the most important thing about it is our first conference win.
Tell us about that. It was Fort Valley not actually in the conference, but the game was designated as a Gulf South Conference game.
Well, we probably won't be able to straighten the schedule out until around 96 when they get all the Arkansas schools in, so we're playing everybody. And until that time, they designate a game that counts as a conference game, so it was very important to us.
Stanley Flanders, the fine receiver, had a big night.
Yeah, Stanley did. He really put on a show, and he and Robert Williams both probably developing into two of the better wide receivers in the nation.
A lot of highlights to show you. Stay with us. We'll look at the first half highlights when we come back.
I'm bored. Let's count the palm trees again. Why are you looking at me like that, Iggy?
You okay?
Cut it out. You're weirding me, man.
Stop looking at me like that, would ya? You're creeping me out. Cut that out, man.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Iggy, you're gonna twist my head off. Iggy.
Most places make their hamburgers from beef that's been frozen. We don't think they taste as good as hamburgers made with fresh beef. That's why at Wendy's, we use only fresh beef. Take our 99 cent junior bacon cheeseburger. We make it hot off the grill with two full strips of bacon, not halves, and we charge just 99 cents. With our super value menu, you can get a great meal for not a lot of money.
At Wendy's, you don't pay more, you just get more.
Deep in the heart of Texas, and adored by lovers of the Old West, is Fort Worth. A city that not only has its own stock market, but is also a major financial center, because it's one of the 1,900 communities served by Nations Bank. Letting Justin Industries keep in step with the latest ideas in investment banking, giving families like the Trevinos a fresh start, and offering a range of resources that keeps people in Fort Worth from having to play second fiddle to anyone.
Thanks for joining us on the Hal Mumme Show. Coach, you're coming off a big win last week, probably the biggest win in school history, a 31-14 victory over Central Florida. You come back with this ball game against Fort Valley. Was there any concern by your coaching staff that your team might have a letdown?
Sure, John. You know, anytime that happens, you've got to worry about that. But all season long, we've been preaching to them that the most important games are the conference games. And, of course, like we discussed at the beginning of the show, it was an official conference game, although they're not in our conference. So we had to work a little extra hard at that to make sure that the players understood that. But really, I think our senior leadership took hold about Tuesday, and we had our best two workouts on Tuesday and Wednesday we've had all year.
Let's go to the first half highlights of the ball game. Weather was a little inclement early. Thought you might have some rain, but cleared up and turned out to be pretty nice.
Well, it kind of ran everybody out warm up there for a while, didn't it? But as it turned out, by game time, it was a pretty decent field. It was a little bit slow.
Yeah, it started to look like it was getting to in the middle of the field, a little bit boggy there, but certainly didn't slow you down. Fort Valley wins the toss, elects to receive, so right away you open the game kicking off, and a little respect for the return man.
Well, last year, you know, they ran one back on us, and they had those same return guys back there, Poole and Taylor, again this year, so we told Vernon to kick it down on the ground there, and I think the footing hurt Vernon. Here we got a couple of great defensive plays to begin the game here. Got to see Jason Jelks on coverage right there, and Ed Mitchell and Andre Hampton made that first stop.
And, good job there.
Pressure by Shea Williams and fumble by Tommy.
Caused by Johnson. Tommy Johnson, right, yes. Fort Valley, three plays and a punt, and your offense goes right to work.
I got a little swing pass here to Steve Greer. We opened up with that last week, so we thought we'd do the same this week. And then a draw play to Dominique Ross. Gets a great block by Stanley Flanders downfield right there, and finally knocked him out of bounds. And then we're going to have a sweep here by Billy Poole. Getting a good block here by Justin Clark, Matt Moore, Drew McPhail. That's Dominique Ross out in front.
Billy Poole enjoys running that play there. Had a touchdown last week against Central Florida on the same play.
He really loves that. Yeah. He loves that sweep play. And then we go to work here with Hatcher, a nice little touch pass to Jimmy King. King's usually uses the blocker for us, but we decided to get him involved in the offense a little more catching. So he had two catches last night.
Chris Hatcher again, very sharp, 24 of 31 for 317 yards, and Ross here gets your first touchdown.
Did a great job. Chris checked that one at the line, and you know, more important than Chris's passing, just his leadership and his field and generalship, and he, you know, a couple of these big touchdown runs by Dominique, he checked here at the line.
Got a good block from Justin Clark and I think Sean Brandon over on the right side.
Right. That was Vernon Laurie getting our extra point with Jamie DeLoach's hold, and Rodney Rigdon's snap. Pressure here by Mike Berry, and I believe that's Shea Williams on the bottom there.
Right.
You can see Andre Hampton and Rasmus Harvey in there.
Shea Williams, the senior from Fort Valley, so probably a big game for him.
Well, all these players know each other, and so they're pretty excited about playing against each other. Here's a big stop on fourth down by defense. Just did a tremendous job, creates a turnover here on downs.
Ball goes over to the Blazers as a Blazer D stops them on a fourth down play, and here goes Billy Poole.
Billy had a play designed to go the right side, and Billy bounced it back to the left and only had one man to beat. Tyrone Poole there from Fort Valley knocks him out of bounds. And of course, Tyrone runs about a 4.340, so that was a pretty good job on Billy's part to do on the sprint.
Billy Poole finishes night 8 carries for 91 yards.
Really tried hard to get him 100 at the end, and we just couldn't quite get it done. But he had a great night. We just missed on this pass to Stanley Flanders, just a little bit underthrown. Chris comes back, puts this one right on the money. Stanley's worth the post offs for a touchdown.
Got a lot of man coverage, it looked like, in the first half, and you're able to really exploit that.
We really did. I think they were hoping to take care of Stanley and Robert Williams with Tyrone Poole, but we moved Stanley to split in during the week, and so it left Stanley one-on-one with one of the younger corners.
Nice job. You see the Blazer cheerleaders. The Blazing Brigade band back with school just about starting, so it was a nice crowd and good to have the students back.
They're doing a great job. Director Mark Belcher does a tremendous job. And
great play there by Tommy Johnson.
Yeah, Andre Randall helping out right there. Ryan Branch in on the mix there. Our defense just had an outstanding night. But didn't allow a first down until late in the first half. It's Robert Williams catching a little slant right there. You can see there's a little feeling on each side here. People don't understand. Nobody really knows what's going on out there for it in terms of innuendo and talk and stuff like that. Great protection by our offensive line here. Robert Williams makes a big time play right there.
And just took it away from the free safety there.
Yeah, you gotta have lots of confidence in your receiver throw that right there. And Hatch obviously does. Stephen Foote, Drew McPhail, Matt Moore, Tommy Clark, Sean Brandon in there in the offensive line doing a great job of pass protection and just knocking them off the ball here so that Dominique can get in.
Ross with his second touchdown of the night. I think you had over 400 yards of offense in the first half.
We were very pleased with our offensive execution in the first part of the game. And it was really great because it gave us a chance to play some of the younger players, which we see in the second half.
Here you get a big play by your defense.
Yeah, Ed Mitchell, I think it was Marcus Johnson, knocked it up there. Ed Mitchell picks it off, convoyed down the sideline there by Tony Hill and Andre Randall.
That's a good block, and you might consider Ed Mitchell for a running back position.
Well, he was a running back at Waycross High School, and he was a running back his first year in junior college. The bunch of pro scouts were in the press box last night looking at him as a safety. He's got a tremendous speed.
So at the start of the second quarter, you come right back. Here's Ross on a little delay route, takes it all the way down to the one-yard line. Then he'll finish it up here from 1 yard out for another, his third touchdown of the night.
Gets a good block from Reggie Walker and Jimmy King out there. At this point, we're kind of feeling a little more comfortable about things. Got Charlie Walsh in there now on the offensive line. There's David Banks. David did a good job blocking for us.
Here you're up a four touchdown lead. Last year you led 35-3 at half against us, but they really showed some signs of life and came back at that point.
Yeah, we were a bit concerned about that. And our guys did a good job holding them down. It's Keith Braddock, the captain of our special teams. Keith's a senior and backup safety, but he's the captain of the special teams. Did a great job getting down there. There's Andre Hampton getting a sack. I think we had four sacks on him.
Hampton sacking Misha Porter in the end zone for a safety. So.
Big play
defense,
right there.
Another big play by your defense there.
Made the score to us. Made it 30, and of course we get to take over the ball after they punted it.
Didn't take long.
Did not take Hatcher and Flanders long to find the end zone.
Stanley Flanders, the Bainbridge native, a big game. 8 catches, 155 yards, 4 touchdowns. That's a tie to school record for points in a game, touchdowns in a game, and touchdown receptions in a game.
Matt Fiorelli could have had another safety right there, just missed on him. And then they break off with a big play here. Marcus Johnson tries to strip the ball, but they did a good job getting the ball out of the end zone, and down threatening us, but Shea Williams and Andre Hampton put stops on that with another sack.
You talked about the referee said we're going to limit some of the enthusiasm. Didn't want any problems.
Yeah, Artie Cobb was the referee, and they did a great job. They were from the SIAC, from Fort Valley's conference, and I was a bit concerned about that going in the game, but actually it was one of the best call games we ever had. My compliments to Artie and his crew.
Blazer offense going right back to work. Hatcher to Robert Williams, the senior from Washington, Georgia.
And then Hatch finds guess who in the end zone again.
And he's not through yet. He's still got more to show you in the second half. But Blazers, as you see, still plenty of time. We're only halfway through the second quarter, and you got a 44-0 lead. Got to be feeling pretty good right now.
Well, I was hoping that we could execute this well. And defensively, I was hoping we'd play as well and with as much enthusiasm as we did the week before. And we obviously are. Although we do bust a coverage right here, and they get in the end zone.
That's right. Richard Smith to Michael Trigg for a 42-yard pass play. The lone score for Fort Valley, the point after, did fail.
This is close to the end of the half. Now we find Steve Greer over the middle. That was a fourth down play right there. And then Hatch is going to come back here. Lots of time to throw.
Exactly.
Find Steve again.
Just going to say that. Plenty of time to throw all night.
And just for the hat trick, we're going to hit Greer again here, 3 in a row for a touch.
Tom Greer made a nice catch, the senior from Athens, just kind of shielded his body to keep the defender away. 51-6 at halftime, as you can see, a school record for points in the first half. Stay with us. When we come back, we'll look at the second half highlights. Welcome back to the Hal Mumme Show, Coach. 51-6, you're leading Fort Valley State at halftime. It's a game you want to play everybody, but that's not really the case because of it being a conference game.
Yeah, John, unfortunately our conference has ruled we can only suit up 55 players, and so we had 28 defensive players suited up and 27 offense. So, you know, even you'd like to be able to substitute your third stringers and that kind of thing, but most of those guys were not fortunate enough to be able to suit up this week. So that was one of the downsides of the game, and so we ended up having to play some of our first team players a little bit longer than we wanted to, just simply because we didn't have any backups.
Right. Let's look now at the second half highlights. Did you have a plan coming in with your first group? Did you say, hey, let's play one series, good solid series?
Well, we wanted to prevent what happened the year before, you know, where they started a little rally, and there's a good pass to Stanley Flanders to get us started.
It's Fort Valley is a team, Coach Doug Porter, they kind of exemplify his character. They don't ever quit.
No, they won't ever quit. And so you got to be careful of that because they can score a lot of points in a hurry. So we wanted to get a score was our goal, John, to answer your original question. And then we wanted to sit down, you know, most of our senior starters.
Billy Poole coming back, and now you'll see Hatcher finding who else but Stanley Flanders once again in the end zone.
Well, they tried to double our flanker all night with the free safety and Poole, and so it left Stanley one-on-one with that corner over there, and Stanley just had a good night.
Certainly did. Makes a premium of catching passes. Seems like every one or two that he catches is a touchdown.
Well, the officials kind of put a stop on that dancing stuff last night, so Stanley really didn't know what to do after he got the end zone. We had to direct him back to the bench a few times.
Now, here's a group that knows what to do. They've got to do push-ups for every touchdown, so they're going to have some big chest here by the end of the season.
We're devoted to getting them to be able to take their shirt off at the beach in the spring break.
And once again, a swarming defense flying around the ball.
Good shot of Jamie Deloach there, our backup quarterback for the Lions. Jamie did a good job in there.
Another big play here as Marcus Smith steps in front of the pass.
Marcus Johnson. That's all right. Marcus is
the senior from Americus,
right. From Americus and does a tremendous job.
He had a big game against Central Florida with 14 tackles.
Here's Jamie Deloach. First attempt here is a little bit high to Tyrell Andrews. Jamie threw some good passes. He was a victim of, you know, we did have some second and third string receivers in the game. A lot of times the timing's not exactly what you like. But here he gets Angelo Williams on the screen pass.
Do you change any of your play calling there to try and get, you know, build him some confidence, some easy throws, anything like that, or do you pretty much stick with the game plan?
We try to get some easy throws. Of course, you're not too worried about the game plan at this point in terms of, you know, actually scoring. We were just trying to run some clock down and not have to put our guys in harm's way, like trying to run the ball every snap or something like that, because it's not something we do naturally as an offense.
And again, you see Andre Hampton with another tackle.
Yeah.
Defense still flying around the football.
But there's an example of what I was talking about, of having to leave guys like Andre Hampton on the field, because we only had one backup, and the backup had already played about a third of the snaps in the first half. Here's James Lockhart making a good breakup on the ball here.
Defense does a good job, holds them to 215 yards, and now another quarterback. You've got Matt Mumme in.
Well, there was a lot of political pressure from home to get that one in the game, I promise you. But
right.
Matt did a credible job here, does real good. Gets a completion to Billy White, and another one coming up here, Jimmy King. Getting some good protection here. But you see Matt Moore, we had an injury in the O-line. We got our starting left guard in there, but we don't have any charge with anybody else.
Right.
And there's Jimmy King. And Coach Porter, very gracious, as always, in defeat or victory. He's a great gentleman.
Yeah, he certainly does a great job with that program. So, as we'll see, the Blazers run their record to 3-0 with the final 58-6.
You can see a lot of our players, there's a lot of feeling on both sides. They all know each other.
A lot of them talking after the ball game to each other. And again, a big night offensively to get the 58 points. Some other Gulf South Conference scores. Livingston gets their first victory over Kentucky State. West Georgia, Coach, looking really strong early.
West Georgia's Coach Fisher and them got a great team up there. They've already beat Georgia Southern. They get nationally ranked Albany State and blank them.
North Alabama blanking Mississippi College, so North Alabama will maintain their number one ranking. Delta State and Harding battle to a 24-24 tie.
I think Delta State's got a good team.
East Texas State knocks off Henderson State by a score 25-13, and it's McNeese State over Central Arkansas. McNeese State with a pretty good program.
Yeah, they're a playoff team in 1AA.
Quickly, the Gulf South Conference standings, VSU on top at 1-0, a four-way tie right now with North Alabama, West Georgia, and Central Arkansas. So still early, but good to see the Blazers.
The way we like it to be right
on
there,
on the top. Stay with us. When we come back, we'll talk with this week's guest, VSU Assistant Athletic Director for Sports Medicine, Jim Madalena.
The way I see it, people don't always have the time to put something good on the table for their families. So I'm going to do it for them.
Hurry up, children, honey.
That way, when they get home, they'll have something good waiting for them. You have to remember, I first made my original recipe chicken for my own family. 11 herbs and spices, and I pressure cooked it. Nothing like it. I just like to think my family got a little bigger, that's
all. Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
If you give someone a good meal at a fair price, they'll come back to you.
Always the finest. The finest U.S. choice beef. Aged for tenderness. And now the 1/8 inch trim, because we know you like it lean. That's WD brand U.S. choice beef. From Winn-Dixie, the beef people.
When I tore up my knee, I thought my life was over. I mean, how klutzy can you be to step off a curb and end up in a heap? But thanks to the folks at the Houston Sports Medicine Center in Columbus, I'm back in the game. After all, if they're good enough for the pros.
The Hawks push the ball up the court, bounce pass to Dominique. He jams it home and led up by 10 with less than a minute.
The Houston Sports Medicine Center in Columbus, Georgia. You don't need million-dollar knees to need us.
Tired of waiting in long checkout lines when you have just a few items and you're in a rush? Come to Swanee Swifty instead. It's fast, easy, and there's one just around the corner. Plus, you'll find practically everything under the sun. Stop in and gas up or pick up groceries or a snack to go. The Swanee Swifty store. They're on your way, so you can be on your way. Stop by today and save.
At your Swanee Swifty store.
We're very pleased to have Assistant Athletic Director of Sports Medicine, Jim Madalena, as our guest on this week's edition of the Hal Mumme Show. Jim, thanks for joining us.
Appreciate it, John.
Jim, tell us a little bit. We've got a unique situation here. You're involved as the head athletic trainer for all the sports, but you also play a big role in academics here.
Right. We are a unique program in that we are the only nationally accredited athletic training / sports medicine major in the state of Georgia. In fact, in the states of Georgia and Florida, there are only two nationally accredited programs, of which obviously we are lucky enough to be one of them.
Tell us about how many kids are in the program.
We have 24 students who are majors in sports medicine. They are accepted by grade point average at the end of their sophomore year. Each student we have to be at an 8-to-1 ratio with regards to certified athletic trainers to student ratios, meaning that myself, Michelle Garber, and Bobby Tucker, the three full-time certified athletic trainers on staff, are responsible directly for 8 students under us. So that would be 8 times 3, or 24 students that are allowed by the nationally accrediting body for our major here at Valdosta State.
Well, certainly, I know as a former athlete, you always appreciate the job that trainers do. It really is a tough job.
Well, we really don't get a lot of the credit, but that's good, because when something goes wrong, we get a lot of the blame, but not as much as we would if we were taking a lot of the credit.
Jim, thanks for joining us. When we come back, some closing comments. Welcome back to the Hal Mumme Show for some closing comments, Coach. Coming up, Clark at Atlanta University.
Yeah, John, you know, Clark is, they came down here last year and led us after the first quarter and had a couple big plays on us. We finally ended up subduing them, you know, in the second half. But we're looking for a good game this week. We need everybody to turn out to Cleveland Field, give us a lot of support like they did last week.
All right, Coach, the weekly tradition, tell us about the song of the week.
Well, this one's, you know, we're three games in the season. This is for coaches out there because coaches can identify with this song. It's titled Migration.
It's one of my favorites, an old Jimmy Buffett one from way back.
That's so, right.
Let's look forward to hearing it. That's going to wrap up this week's edition of the Hal Mumme Show. We thank you for joining us. Join us next week for the highlights as VSU tangles with Clark at Atlanta University. We'll see you then. Teach them how to fuss and pull the cook out of-